So let me just say a few words. Happy Thanksgiving once again to everyone. As I think all of you know that our group went to Mindanao to serve our people there, the Manobo tribes. These are a little tribe up there in the mountains of Mindanao. And our group contributed to something to give these people out there. And when we were brought to that mountain, we rode on a truck that is four-wheel truck. Only a four-wheel vehicle can reach the mountain, up on top of the mountain. And it took us about 3 hours. It's only maybe about 4 kilometers, but it took us 3 hours because of so the road was like even rougher than the surface of the moon. The stones, there are many potholes in there, and we crossed many rivers, and yet this truck could go through all those rugged terrain. And when we got there, our students of our high school there up in the mountain, about 200 of them. We have a high school up in the mountain. We are the only ones that has a school on top of the mountains on these Manobo tribes. And you know, they were all in uniform. Their uniforms are so bright. And once you see them, you know, you get excited. And they treated us with their Manobo tribe dance, and I really love the way they dance. And after their dance, their singing, we gave them a package of gifts, every one of them, more than 200 of them. And you know, those gifts were toothbrush, bar soap, toothpaste. And according to the principal, that was the first time these students received a full bath soap and a toothbrush and a toothpaste. And they were so very grateful. The principal and the teachers told us, you know, some of these students are kids of the NPH here. That's why nobody can touch our school up there in the mountain, because if you touch anybody of our students there, the NPHs who live up there in the mountain, they said these are the nice people around. Or the new people army, they call them. But we don't use the new people army there, they just call nice people around. So if you touch our school there, be careful, the NPH will run after you. And the director of the Sulad, they call it Sulad. Sulad is a name, is a word of these Manobos. I don't know the meaning, but anyway, it's a good word. And the school is so grateful to us for giving all these gifts. And some of these gifts come from you, from Virginia Beach. We have some groups from Maryland too. And there were about nine of us. And each one donated so much to build gazebos in our school. You know, our gazebos there that we made, we helped build the gazebos there. One of them maybe would cost about $20,000 a year. Beautiful, very presentable. But because labor up in Mindanao is so cheap, we were able to build it for only about Mr. Montanello here is an architect, a builder. It only cost us around $7,000+. And we built 3 gazebos. The price of that in our place here would cost us around $60,000. But it's a free labor, you know? And that's why our people there are very happy for the help that they received from our people here in the United States. And of course, I visited my adopted mother. I have a mother who died 17 years ago, but I was adopted by her sister. Her sister is still alive. She is 101 years old. I was so happy to see her alive, but down deep in my heart, I was crying because she could not remember me anymore. Her memory is gone. You know what I mean? And she has no sickness. She's very strong. She eats well. She could speak. And every time in her room, she is picking up everything around her room. She's very clean because she lives. She was a clean woman. And until her memory left her, now she still cleans. And she doesn't know anybody around her. And when I saw her, I introduced myself. She doesn't know me anymore. So right inside me, there's pain. I was bleeding inside. But I had to overcome that. And then Apostle Paul says, I remember what Apostle Paul says, for everything, give thanks. For everything, give thanks. It's so hard to give thanks when you see your loved one suffering. But anyway, the Apostle Paul says, for everything, give thanks. And I'm so proud of our country, the Philippines. I've seen malls there, bigger than the malls I've seen here in the United States. How could a small nation, poor nation like ours, could build big malls? That is my surprise. Malls that are much bigger than the malls here in the United States. And people there, I think they have money. You could hardly walk through the mall because people are just buying everything. For everything, give thanks. I just thank God that in spite of the poverty of our country, and yet they look like they have all the money. One morning, in fact, two mornings last week, at 3 o'clock, a group of singers, just like normal singers, were serenading us early in the morning, 3 o'clock. And I told my wife, what shall we do? I've never been serenaded before. So I came out and said, I'm sorry, I don't know what your problem is. Christmas caroling? Would you need some money? And they said, of course. Of course, there, you know, your 1,000 pesos will go a long way. And when they see a 1,000 pesos, you know, you think that's big? That's not much. It's only about $22. But 1,000 pesos, you know, they jump for joy to see 1,000 pesos. And then the following morning, somebody came again. For everything, give thanks. So everywhere we go, I know now that, you know, when they come to you, they want money. So I have my money ready here for me. But I just praise God that we are the ones giving away, right? Not receiving the money. So if you have money, give it away. Because one of these days, you will not be able to give away money anymore. And I thank God for the privilege that I was able to join this group to serve our people there in the mountains and in the Philippines. And the whole of Mountain View, my son spoke 1 week there every morning and every evening, morning and evening. And I spoke in the churches around and also in the villages. A group, they have groups there, every morning.